Hello, good morning. Welcome to RaW Daily Show. I remember my humble self, Chuka Obelago. You can call me Chooks, you can call me Chuck. Welcome to the midweek. So I have just a couple of questions to ask you. How are you close to achieving this week's goal? Because we just have only 3 days to go. And what challenges are you facing? What lessons are you learning from those challenges? What do you think you need to become better so that you'll be able to achieve this week's goal? Now, all this will be addressed in today's episode titled Job's Effect. It's not Job's Effect, it's Job's Effect. Most of us who are Christians, who have read the Bible, know about the life of Job, who was rich beyond all riches, had a very big family, farm, workers. Things are going on happy in his life. Till the Almighty Lord gave the devil the permission to test Job's faith and believe in him. And Job automatically lost everything. His business, his farm, his workers. Lost one of, some of his children. And also, worst of all, he fell sick. Very deep sickness that he was completely incapacitated to lift himself and go do something about his challenges. His friends, his wife, people around him were against him, telling him, "This God you are serving, where is he now? This God that you have faith in, where is he now? Let him come to your rescue. You can't even help yourself. You can't even clean your own mess." That's what I mean by the Job's effect. But what happened when he didn't give up his faith on God? His life turned around, and those things he had before were tripled. Tripled beyond bounds, that he became more richer and more richer than he was before. So this story is what I use to illustrate the Job's effect. That is that period in your life, it doesn't happen all the time. It just comes once in a while where you're close to achieving a very important goal in your life. When you're close to getting to a particular place, to break free or to break through a particular point in your life and to get to the highest, to the next level. Challenges come up from nowhere that you don't expect. Some come from the past, some come from what happens now. I don't know about what comes from the future. Maybe anxiety, maybe fear of the future, and the rest of it all. So these things, attend them with Job's effect, because it's meant to happen once in a while in your life. Not even once. It's going to happen each time you're close to undergoing a very big transformation in your life to get to where you want to be. Most of us have set their goals for this week and looking forward to achieving those goals. But what happened? Certain things happened. Life happened. You couldn't phantom these things because you didn't see them coming. You couldn't make a backup plan because you didn't know such things were going to happen. That's one thing about the future. But there are two things you can do about it. There is one, you can either react by complaining, or you can either accept that this is happening, learn from it, and become better. Because who you were before the challenges come is not going to be who you will become when you overcome these challenges. So this is very key. It's a mindset thing. It's a mindset thing. Because why I say it's a mindset thing is because it's something you need to calm yourself down. You know, a period where you are scared, where you are afraid, where fear is trying to overrule your emotion, and push you to start making instant decisions, actions, and you end up making more and more mistakes. So what do you do when you are in times like this? First thing you need to do is take a pause. P-A-U-S-E, pause. Take a pause, sit down, and review this challenge again, even up to 5 times, again and again and again and again. Why? Because if you don't do it this way, you'll find it hard accepting it and say, okay, this is here. I can't fight it, because what you resist persists. So the only way is for you to do is accept it, learn from it, and learn pick up what you need to learn so that you're not going. So slow pause, please press the pause button, sit down, review your situation, look at the problem, embrace it. Then secondly, what you now do is ask yourself, what is this trying to teach me? What am I supposed to learn from this? Because if you don't learn from it, definitely when it comes back again, it will beat you hands down. But when you learn from it, it makes you stronger, it makes you thicker, and next time it comes, you're more wiser to handle it. And at the same time, if you're able to handle it, a more bigger challenge is going to come. That's how we grow. I've come to realize that's how we grow. Every time I'm at a breaking point, something will always come up. Whether it's from the past, or whether it's from my current actions, it will always come to try to slow me down and deviate me from the goal that I set for myself. But if you don't have control over your mind that scares easily, you lose control. So when after asking yourself this question, the next thing you need to do is, what am I supposed to do? What skills do I need to learn for me to move myself from this place forward? What things do I need to do or need to stop doing so that I can move myself from this place going forward? It's plain simple. When you're able to review yourself, ask yourself what you're meant to learn, definitely the things you need to learn, the skills you need to learn, or the knowledge, or the training you need to have, or whatever seminar you need to attend, whatever it is, or whatever book you need to read, you will definitely find yourself growing through that process. So this is very, very important to you guys. This is very, very important. This is very, very key, because most of us miss this. It's easier to complain than to hold your emotions in check and hold your anger and your fear and be able to look at things and assess what you're trying to learn, we're supposed to learn, and how you're going to become better by learning new skills, new things, new knowledge, becoming better. So now you're done with the skills. Automatically, what do you do next? Take actions with what you've had. If it's in your business, you take action with the new knowledge you have. Not only minimum action, massive action. Why? Because massive action is, you take massive action with faith. Believe me, faith needs to be there, because definitely there's still self-doubt that you need to worry about. So massive action with faith. And what's that supposed to do for you? Is your way of cheating time. The challenge came and drew you backwards. And the only way for you to beat time is for you to maximize your action, to maximize your effort, so that you can turn around things on time and attract the law of success to you. So you take massive action, be consistent in the, not only take massive, be consistent in those massive actions. Take them on a day-to-day basis. Set a particular time that suits you and go about it on a day-to-day basis. Believe you me. You will start seeing changes happen. You will start seeing results happen. I see bad times as times that I need to grow, times that I need to learn, times that I need to become a much better person. And I face it squarely. I learn from it, then move on to make a difference in my life and the life of others around me. So now that I'm done with this, I need you to review yourself, review your situation, review whatever stuff you find yourself. It can also help you in the person, your personal life. Because one thing I've come to find out is this. For an entrepreneur, you need to keep your mind in check. You need to keep your emotions in check. That's why Gary Vaynerchuk says that in the real world, emotional quotient is greater than intelligent quotient. What it means, emotional intelligence is far more important than that intelligence you need to learn to pass exams in school and stuff like that. So that's all I have for you today. Hope it adds value to you. Hope it makes sense to you. Make sure you are able to invite your friends, share this to all your friends who didn't come online to listen to me, and help us improve by leaving your comment or your critics. They are welcomed, okay? They are welcome, because those are the things that make us become better. We learn from them and give you better content, okay? These things are not stereotyped. These things are come out from life experiences we have. You might have a different opinion from what we have, okay? But the most important thing is that we got you thinking. I got you taking action. I got you taking charge of your life. So this midweek, with this lesson you've learned, if you're having a hard time in your business or whatever it is you're doing, start now to start implementing what you've heard today. Start now to start taking massive action so that you turn around things for yourself. So by Friday,